Our All-Metro offense is led by Lakeville North quarterback Trey Hyde, who had an amazing season. Hyde can do it all. Watch this crazy scramble. Then somehow the senior has the presence of mind to hit the open receiver for a touchdown. Hyde made things happen with his arm and his legs all season in leading the Panthers to a perfect 8-0 regular season. Hyde completed nearly 60% of his passes for 2,085 yards and 20 touchdowns. He was a threat every time he touched the football. As a runner, he scored 8 touchdowns, totaling 518 yards. He led the Panthers to the state 5A quarterfinals, finishing 10-1. More on Trey Hyde in a minute. Our other All-Metro quarterback is future Gopher Mitch Leidner of Lakeville South. He's a pocket passer at 6'5", 225. Watch Leidner, number 7, deliver this touchdown pass. He finished the season with 1,864 yards and 20 touchdowns. Leidner has a strong arm, great vision. He's tough and extremely competitive. Lakeville South finished with a 7-3 record. Leidner will sign with the Gophers. All Metro running backs are led by Eden Prairie senior Andrew Larson, a repeat Care 11 All Metro performer. Watch Larson, number 28, bust this great touchdown run. The 3-year starter has 1,396 yards on 110 carries and 22 touchdowns. He's also played hurt the second half of the season. Larson is Eden Prairie's all-time leading rusher with 3,823 yards. He has scored 47 career touchdowns and may go down as the best big school running back ever in Minnesota. South St. Paul senior workhorse Sam Sura is also a repeat Care 11 All-Metro player. Watch Sura, number 31, bust this long touchdown run. The 185-pound back was voted the Classic Suburban Offensive Player of the Year, and you can see why. He finished with 1,700 yards on 220 carries and 22 touchdowns. Sura is a tough runner, getting many of his yards after contact. He led the Packers to a 10-2 season and a berth in the state 4A quarterfinals. Wayzata running back Antonio Ford is an explosive runner who's led the Trojans to an undefeated record. Watch the senior, number 25. He flat out runs hard. The 5'9", 200-pound Ford has 1,269 yards on 194 carries in 11 games. Watch this great touchdown run. He's averaging over 6 yards per carry with 12 rushing touchdowns. Wayzata has currently won 22 straight games. Anoka senior fullback Josh Wernis is a bruising runner in the Tornadoes wing T offense. Watch Wernis, number 32, take off on this big touchdown run. He was voted the Northwest Suburban Conference most valuable player, and for good reason. He finished the season with 192 carries for 1,454 yards. He also has a nose for the end zone, scoring 15 touchdowns for Anoka as the Tornadoes finished 9-2. Our All-Metro receivers are led by Division I recruit Andre McDonald of Hopkins High School. He's 6'3", 212 pounds. Watch McDonald, number 12, on this great catch and run for a touchdown. The senior is the total package of size, speed, and hands. He finished the season with 60 catches for 1,251 yards and 17 touchdowns. McDonald, the repeat All-Metro player, averaged 20 yards per catch this season. He was tough to stop after the catch, finishing his career with 138 receptions for 2,699 yards and 39 touchdowns. Roseville receiver Amici Wells was voted the Suburban East Conference Offensive Player of the Year. Watch this great catch in traffic by Wells, number 6. He's a big-time player at 6'4", 190 pounds, and he has great hands. Wells finished the season with 37 catches for 610 yards and 7 touchdowns. He also rushed for over 500 yards and 4 TDs. He's a great player on what was an average football team. He isn't big at 6'1", 165, but Lakeville South receiver Matt Heller is one heck of a receiver. Watch number 13, Heller, make this diving catch. South head coach Larry Thompson says Heller has great hands and is the most elusive player in the state. Heller finished the season with 52 catches for 869 yards and 11 touchdowns. He's being recruited lower level Division I. Lakeville North's Charlie Hayes isn't big either or super fast, but the kid can catch the football. Watch Hayes, number 8, make the long touchdown catch on this play. The senior finished with 60 receptions for 1,033 yards and 8 touchdowns. He was always on the same wavelength with quarterback Trey Hyde. Hayes had the ability to make the tough catch look easy. He finished his career with 77 catches, 11 for touchdown. Our All-Metro offensive line is led by Eden Prairie's Nick Davidson at 6'6", 275 pounds. Watch Davidson, number 52, with a pancake block on this play. He's the most sought-after lineman in Minnesota, and for good reason. Nick is a devastating blocker, a 4-star recruit with all the tools. Behind Davidson, the EP running game is almost impossible to stop. Wayzata left tackle Ben Lauer is 6'7", 275 pounds. This guy's a fabulous blocker. Watch Lauer, number 78, demolish his opponent on this play. The Trojans average over 6 yards per carry, many behind Lauer. When Wayzata needs that critical yard, they run behind Lauer, who is nothing short of a beast. He's being recruited Division I. St. Thomas Academy senior Isaac Hayes is headed to the Gophers on scholarship. He's 6'2", 275. Watch Hayes, number 72, pancake his opponent on this play. He's a devastating blocker with great leverage and technique. Head coach Dave Zebarth says Isaac is the best offensive lineman he's coached in 25 years, and that includes Isaac's older brother, who plays for Stanford. He's a good one. Burnsville's Chase Roulier is a monster of a man at 6'5", 300 pounds. Watch number 74 block on this play. The senior was voted the South Suburban Conference Lineman of the Year. He graded out at 95% with several pancake blocks. Watch Roulier block on this play. He played both offense and defense, recording 60 tackles and 4 sacks. He's being recruited Division I, and for good reason. Anoka tackle Kyle Griffin is 6'4", 240 pounds, but a perfect fit as a blocker in the Tornadoes' wing T offense. Watch Griffin, number 77, seal block on this play, and running back Josh Wernis will take it for a touchdown. Griffin was voted the Northwest Suburban Conference Offensive Lineman of the Year. He was a big reason why Anoka had the best rushing team in the Metro. Edina offensive tackle Kevin Carroll is a big man at 6'3", 285. Watch Carroll, number 75, with this pancake block. He averaged double-digit pancakes in most games. He's a very physical player who's receiving Division I college interest. Watch Carroll block on this play. He put on 30 pounds in the offseason, and that extra muscle and strength paid off. We have 2 All-Metro athletes. The first is Holy Family's Mr. Everything, Michael Roan. Watch Roan, number 13. He played quarterback on offense, rushing for 1,513 yards on 218 carries and 13 touchdowns. He averaged nearly 7 yards per run. As a passer, Roan threw for over 1,270 yards with 13 touchdowns. He accounted for almost 63% of the Fire's offense. On defense, he made 68 tackles, had 2 interceptions, including this one. He was the punter and the kicker. He was a big reason why Holy Family finished 10-2. Our other All-Metro athlete is St. Croix Lutheran senior Wesley Tucker. Watch Tucker, number 28, score a touchdown on this run. He has 150 carries for 1,553 yards and 25 touchdowns this season. But keep in mind, the Crusaders have blown out almost every opponent, so Tucker hasn't played full games. He never leaves the field. Watch Tucker get the sack on this play. He has 53 tackles this fall. St. Croix Lutheran has a 12-0 record and is ranked number 1 in Class 3A. Our All-Metro kicker is also one of our quarterbacks, Trey Hyde of Lakeville North. Hyde has Division I potential as a kicker. He made 10 of 12 field goals, making 3 from 38 yards out. Hyde has a monster leg with many of his kickoffs resulting in touchbacks. He also averaged 35 yards per punt. He's just a tremendous all-around football player. And our choice for Coach of the Year is Hill Murray's Brooks Bollinger. In his first season as a high school football head coach, Bollinger led the Pioneers to their first ever state tournament win in Hill Murray's first trip to state since 1987. He was hired in the summer to help revive Pioneer football, and he's done an amazing job. Hill Murray beat Matamidi twice in one season, which is a big deal for the Pioneers. Hill has a 9-2 record after finishing 6-5 a year ago. Congratulations to Brooks Bollinger.